Hello, everyone. I'll keep this intro short because I have grim news. TI has officially removed support for assembly and C programming on the TI-84 Plus CE and the TI-83 Premium CE. This means that any assembly game like the beloved Orium, Hailstorm, Minecraft 2D, Pac-Man, Portal, Tetris, Oregon Trail, TI Boy, and hundreds of others, along with utilities like Cesium, overclocking tools, and my high-definition picture viewer, cannot be run on any OS that is 5.5.1 or higher. Before I begin, if this video is outdated, or if there's any new news, I'll plug a card in right now, or put any new information in a pinned comment. Now, you may have read some articles about this, or even seen short video coverage on TechLinked or The WAN Show from Linus Tech Tips. Unfortunately, many of these articles have slight inaccuracies or don't dig into the details enough to understand what the issue really is. Although the video coverage is accurate, I'm going to be going into far more detail about what exactly happened, touch on the history that led up to this, and explain how the situation has developed over the past week or so. I'll also cover how a different calculator company handled a very similar situation, but in a much more reasonable way. If you want to visit any of the sources I mention, I'll cite everything down in the description. If you want to do some additional research, TI Planet wrote a beautiful article about the history of assembly on calculators, and Chemitech is keeping up with the latest news on this situation. If you've never heard of these forums before, you just need to know TI Planet is a very large and reputable French forum. Among the co-founders still active today are Crytor, Adrian Webb, and Lionel Debro. They have been reporting news about TI and other calculator brands for over 10 years. Chemitech is similar to TI Planet, however, it is predominantly English and has been around since 2001. Its founder is Kerm Martian. Enough setup, now on to the report. According to TI Planet's article and a famous community member, Brandon Wilson, before 2007, TI was getting pressured to remove assembly programming on the calculators, but they largely fended it off. However, when TI released their new Inspire calculator lineup in 2007, it marked the beginning of the end of assembly programming on all their calculators. It wasn't until 2018, though, until assembly was tampered with on the TI-84 Plus CE and the TI-83 Premium CE family. When OS 5.2.0 was released in 2017, it contained a bug in exam mode that allowed a user to run programs they shouldn't have been able to run, and from there, it potentially used assembly code, or ASM, to disable exam mode. If you're unfamiliar with exam mode, essentially it's a huge reason why calculators are still around today. In short, it allows teachers and exam proctors to disable features on calculators they don't want students to have access to during exams. Exam proctors and teachers have huge influence over what features TI adds or removes from their calculators. When TI Planet discovered the exam mode bug in late 2017, they reported it properly. They explained it privately to TI, gave them time to fix the bug, and never released any information about it until after the bug showed up independently on what seemed to be a student's video on YouTube. Still, they never described how to exploit the bug themselves. I'd like to note that TI Planet fights cheating in general and publishes information on helping proctors to detect if cheating is happening using known exploits and bugs in general. All seemed well, and OS 5.3.0 contained no additional assembly restrictions. However, it appeared that the pressure to do something about assembly was ever rising on TI. It all changed when OS 5.3.1 was released, which finally fixed the bugs, but now also blocked access to the ASM84CE program token during exam mode. That token was what allowed OS 5.2.0's bug to be even more serious. That was perfectly understandable and a good move to ensure OS 5.2.0's bug would never spring up again. However, TI took the restriction a step too far and permanently removed access to the token even outside of exam mode. Now, this was completely unnecessary and pointless, because the user could simply send over the token through a computer, which is even the official way to get it back, according to TI themselves. I should point out that the ASM84CE program token has many useful features, such as enabling lowercase letters and enabling dark mode. The big issue is very few teachers or exam proctors even use exam mode, opting instead for a simple RAM clear, which is laughably easy to bypass even for a new user. All but a very few students use assembly to cheat. The vast majority simply use TI's built-in program editor to put in notes. The latter way is easily foiled by using exam mode, which disables access to those cheaty notes. The only reason there aren't more cheaters using assembly is because the community took it upon themselves to keep these exploits a tight secret to prevent TI from doing anything drastic to the hobby hundreds of thousands of students enjoy. Now think about this, especially if you're in the US. How many times did your school ever use exam mode? Did they ever make sure your calculator was updated? Do you even know exam mode, aka press to test, was a thing until today? Did your teacher even bother RAM clearing? I know my school certainly never used exam mode and did nothing to properly prevent cheating, likely because a few teachers even knew of the feature. Teachers just expected the calculators to be automatically cheat-proof and don't know to look into it more. The banning of the token was very annoying, but it wasn't cause for upheaval since there are workarounds and there was the ability to downgrade to lower OS versions despite TI's built-in downgrade protection introduced in OS 5.1.5. OS 5.3.6 and OS 5.4.0 came without any other tampering to assembly programming, and the community's frustration with TI largely died down and is replaced by excitement due to faster models of the same calculator being released and TI adding Python support. However, the community was oblivious to the pressure TI was facing to remove assembly support, and what followed next was the last straw. In February, a highly misleading video was posted by a student and a famous YouTuber math teacher that showed a step-by-step process on how to exploit the exam mode bug in OS 5.2.2. They falsely stated that no new S's had been released, making people believe that all CEs were vulnerable to the bug and were unsafe for testing environments, even though the bug had actually been patched for over 2 years. Quick update here. His wording was a little ambiguous. He could have meant that only his calculator was outdated, not that there were no new S's released. Nevertheless, it does not excuse the panic it ended up causing. Devastatingly, the video was seen by quite a few teachers and exam proctors and gained nearly 250,000 views. You can imagine the backlash TI received from these teachers, proctors, and possibly government officials that made TI think they needed to make swift and firm action. Therefore, they made a decision to end the pressure of ASM for good. No one knew about their decision for quite some time, even on the 24th of March when TI gave TI Planet a beta of their next OS to review, OS 5.5.0. This OS contained vast improvements to Python programming and updated a few apps. Assembly appeared to not have been tampered with any further, and the community was excited for the OS to be publicly released in mid-May. May 5th and 6th, before the information went public, TI privately informed Crytor, AgriWeb, and Kerr Martian that assembly would be removed sometime in the upcoming 5.5 release. Due to a non-disclosure agreement, or NDA, these people could not let the information go public until TI allowed them to. On May 9th, the public community got its first hint that something bad was approaching during a Kerr Martian livestream where he replied to a comment I made about finishing his popular assembly show for the TI-84 Plus family. Doors.
I'm very, very sad to say this is actually probably the first place I'm ever saying it. It's unlikely I'll ever complete and publish Door CE. I'll eventually explain why. Not on this stream, at a future date. But yeah, I'm afraid Door CE is unlikely to exist.
However, the community had no idea what could possibly make Kerm completely stop development on such a historically popular shell. Just a few days before the new OS release, TI allowed AgriWeb to inform a few community members about the removal of ASM in order to dampen potential rash instinctive actions. A few of these members informed were old-timers, active community members, well-known program developers, and the maintainers of the popular C toolchain, which would not exist without ASM. On May 20th, TI Planet published their latest article about a beta version of TI's next supposed OS, OS 5.5.0. However, nobody had any idea of what a dirty trick TI was about to pull. Mere hours after TI Planet's last article, TI pulled the rug from under the community's feet, and instead of releasing 5.5.0, they released 5.5.1, which removed all assembly support. Okay, a lot happened in a very short period of time here, so let me slow down and try and condense it all. The community exploded with fury for numerous reasons. First, TI seemed to have drummed up a bunch of positive hype with the promise of new features, then duped its customers by releasing a different OS version instead. Also, TI did not contact the community to compromise and see what they could do to relieve the pressure, while also keeping the community's hobby alive. They just dumped us the new OS and tried to use the members they privately contact to act as damage control. Lastly, and most importantly, TI did not improve their security by one bit. In fact, they destroyed it. Let me elaborate on the security bit. ASM was one of the things that the community feared TI would take away from us ever since 2007. In fact, TI Planet admins have good relations with TI and spend quite some time meticulously reporting all cheating-related exploits that could directly impact TI's business and cause such rash actions. TI Planet and the community have been the backbone of TI's security for years. Suddenly, TI carelessly dismissed all that hard work in the blink of an eye, and the community was beyond furious. This means that TI has lost the most important part of its skeletal security. Just like with OS 5.3.1, TI just targeted the smallest group of potential cheaters possible. Like I explained earlier, many teachers don't even use exam mode, so this has done nothing to stop the casual cheater. It has also done nothing to stop the determined cheater, because teachers don't check OS versions so someone can use an outdated OS on a test. These teachers and exam proctors are forcing TI to make difficult choices because the teachers don't know about, or don't care to do, the trivial steps to stop cheating, like keeping calculators updated and using exam mode in the first place. Over the next few days, the community sent numerous pleas to TI to explain themselves, compromise with the community, or reverse their decision. The community even brainstormed several alternatives that would keep both TI and the community happy. However, TI's official response so far is, "At TI, we are constantly working on ways to improve our products and give students more opportunities to learn, explore, and investigate math and science. After careful consideration, we made the decision to remove ASM functionality in our latest OS update to prioritize learning and minimize security risks." As I just explained, TI actually maximized security risks, and the general community consensus agrees that TI is not prioritizing fun learning, only standard boring learning students have grown to dread. May 22nd, Kerr Martian posted an update stating that TI found the decision to remove ASM difficult but necessary. Instead of using ASM, TI hoped we would focus on Python development that was coming to new calculators. Python could have been good on the new CEs. However, TI botched the hardware implementation. TI's Python calculators contain one of the slowest implementations of Python on a calculator ever. As benchmarked by TI Planet, for the set pixel command, the next two fastest calculators are 100 and 200 times faster, and the next one is 1,000 times faster. This important Python function is so slow you can count the seconds per frame rather than the frames per second when rendering an image. Needless to say, it's no match for assembly code, which can run the same kind of program at dozens of frames per second. May 23rd. In order to ensure TI's dirty trick didn't go unnoticed, I wrote an article on the popular Linus Tech Tips forum explaining the situation as I understood it at the time. My goal is to simply spread the word and potentially get a segment on the news channel called TechLinked. I didn't realize how important that forum was to tech reporters. The very next day, Engadget posted a short article about it. It wasn't long after that several other sites, including Slashdot and Reddit, posted similar articles, spreading the word even more. May 24th. User Dr. Dinar wrote a very respectful, reasonable letter with endorsements from AgriWeb and Krytor. It was sent directly to the president of the Texas Instruments Educational Technology, Dr. Peter Baulita, a longtime proponent of STEM and calculator programming. The letter explained that the community was confused and frustrated by TI's decision, along with asking why TI never asked for the community's input on the situation. Dr. Dinar explained that the community would willingly help TI properly fix their security issues if given the chance. TI could gain free bug testers and programmers out of the situation. Crushingly, Dr. Belita has yet to respond. The same day, Kerr Martian sparked discussion about a theoretical developer TI-84 plus CE, which could not be used on exams, but would be ideal for developers. Unfortunately, none of the solutions brought up were very feasible. TI would not make much profit off of a new calculator not designed for students. Also, one of the fun features about calculators was that anyone with the same model could just run your program without any fuss. May 25th. There was good news in terms of publicity. TechLink did give a segment to touch on the news on their show. The video gained over 800,000 views and massively helped spread the word. There was even a post on the Linus Tech Tips forum with the idea of a full coverage video about benchmarking different calculators' programming options. Unfortunately, the good news was dampened when TI gave the community another figurative middle finger in a response by TI support team, TI Cares. In the email, TI claimed that now running any game voids the calculator's warranty. The email just raised more questions. Did it mean ASM games? Did it cover BASIC or Python games? Why don't utilities void the warranty? TI gave the community one last punch in the gut as of recording in a tweet that advertised OS 5.5.1 but never mentioned anything about removing assembly support. Even worse, TI left in assembly programming as one of the features of the TI-83 Premium CE on its official page, which is just false advertisement. Not long after, TI received complaints about its users finding out the hard way that assembly programming was actually disabled and there was no way to downgrade. There wasn't much more development on the situation for several days. On May 29th, Linus Tech Tips mentioned and explained the situation to its viewers on the popular livestream called WAN Show. The host expressed their frustration with how TI handled the situation.
It's just a crappy move and makes absolutely no sense and makes no difference whatsoever. And really all that's serving to do is antagonize that community that has been around for so long and put them in a position where they might start trying to break the security rather than, you know, protect these secrets.
In fact, TI's poor responses caused some users to bring out the pitchforks and torches, figuratively speaking, and started looking for ways of hacking in assembly code. These exploits are kept private as time of recording, however they could be released at any time. Some users are even strategizing how and when to release the carefully crafted exploits to ensure ASM can stay hacked into calculators for as long as possible. None of these users want this to happen, but they feel that TI has stabbed them in the back enough times so that calls for war against their decisions. You may be thinking that any company would handle the situation the same way if put in TI's shoes. However, that is simply not the case. As reported by user Jean-Baptiste Boric, another calculator company called Numworks was put in a similar situation. A user rebuilt the firmware and removed lines of code that would remove programs when they entered exam mode. The user proceeded to create a misleading post about their work, which found its way to the Dutch Ministry of Education and Exams Office. The article claimed that since Numworks' firmware was open source, it was easy to change the firmware without being caught. This was misleading because TI's firmware and even Casio's firmware can be patched in a similar way, even though they are closed source. Therefore, open source is completely unrelated. When the situation started getting out of control, instead of choosing to make the OS closed source or remove programming altogether, Numworks reached out to its community for advice. The community discussed numerous solutions with Numworks, none of which involved preventing running native apps or custom firmwares. Although Numworks is eating a noticeable chunk of the graphing calculator market, at least in France, they didn't let hubris be their downfall. Numworks is an example of a large company that doesn't just claim it cares about its community, it shows its community that it cares about them. As I'm sure you've noticed, the Numworks community hasn't been furiously trying to get a whole situation reversed because they have a company that listens to them. So there you go. That's just about everything that's happened over the past several days. It's just a terrible situation, and the community is doing our best to come to terms with TI before the situation turns into a sad cat and mouse game between some developers and TI. So what can you do if you want to let TI know you disapprove of their actions? If you're a teacher or exam proctor, you have the most leverage. Contact TI through their support site, TI Cares. Link is in the description. Everyone else, it would also be helpful if you contacted TI about this. If you want to see a video of benchmarking calculators, go support the post on the LTT thread. If you want to go a step further, don't buy a TI calculator. Numworks, HP, and Casio have great calculators, sometimes for far cheaper. If you must buy a TI calculator, just get one used and don't update, ever. The only way TI is going to listen to their consumers is if we hurt their wallets. Thanks for sitting through this lengthy video. All my sources are in the description. Go have a good day.